Hello everyone, and welcome to a new Let's Play. I'm Rise of Geek, and as you can probably tell, today we are playing the HD release of Ico's games, Ico and Shadow of the Colossus. Both games I loved on PS2, and had to get again once they had a HD release. Today we're going to start Ico. It's the game I'm less familiar with out of the two. I remember I did complete Ico once. Shadow of the Colossus I completed a few times, at least the game part of it. We'll get to the time trials later. So Ico I finished once all the way through, but I have played it since then, just not all the way through. Not recently, I'd like to admit. I just want to point out at this point, because I'm pretty sure you can hear it, I hope you can. I love the music in both Ico and Shadow of the Colossus. It's amazing. Now, if you don't know what Ico is, well, you're about to see. Let's crack on. Yeah, so I mean to get this game for a long time, and because I did have on PS2, and I always hate myself for it. I did sell like my entire PS2 library at one point. I'm slowly piecing it back together again, but this is the PS3 version, so it means there's trophies, and I think graphically it's supposed to be smoother, but I can't remember if it looked rough on PS2 because it was a while ago. It's a very story-driven game. So I'll probably be quiet over these bits. At least I'll try to. I know a lot of people prefer to make connections between this game and Shadow of the Colossus, like whether the kid in this is actually the young man in Shadow of the Colossus. It's possible, it's interesting. I don't think it makes much difference to the story either way. Ico. Oh, sorry, I've got a bit of a sore throat today, so sorry if I cough a lot. Okay, so I wasn't even being in the game. That was literally the title screen. New game. As you can see, I haven't played it on the PS3 this time yet. There's a lot of fade to whites in these cutscenes, I'm trying to remember correctly. Hoping that won't annoy anyone too much. I know it didn't when the game came out. That's one of the criticisms I heard a lot, was this constant fade to white, just piss people off. There we go again. I love playing games with these headphones now because there's so much more atmosphere. Ooh, loud. Atmospheric, loud. That's not a sentence you like hearing when you're being led somewhere. Not that I'd know. Thank you. this is one of those games that was always hard to classify as like genre. So I think it was always just part of the action adventure, but I don't think you can classify this game really. In some places you can. But as you'll see, it's not like other games, and Shadow of the Colossus even more so, which I will be doing a series on, I'm sure. But probably be like hard mode or time trials. This way I was going on doesn't look wholesome, does it? So, I'm pretty sure he's being sacrificed, is what this is all about. For the good of the village, which you never get to see the village as far as I know. I always wonder whether that means that all those others are actually full of children. Horns on his head, I'm pretty sure, actually, like, horns. They're not, like, a helmet or anything like that. Like, the other guys had helmets with horns on. But I'm pretty sure this boy has horns. He seems to be taking this fairly well. Standard everyday ink spillage. I don't remember this. Okay. So what do we take from that? That the black inky stuff is bad. And we're back here. Okay. Ah, now we're actually playing. Okay, so of course it's the analog stick to move. It's on PS3, of course. X does nothing. Square does nothing. Triangle jumps with a really weird static. You can't move while jumping jump unless you're already pressing move. Circle makes him walk slow. R1 makes him shout, meh, or meh, not sure. R2 zooms in, camera. L2 does nothing, L1 does nothing. Okay, is there a grab button? Okay, so circle's the grab button. I know there are a few secrets in the game, like there's like things you can miss. I think there's a weapon you can miss if you're not looking in the right place. Like I said, I haven't played this in a long time, especially all the way to the end. So if I make mistakes, it's because I just don't know what I'm doing, pretty much. Okay, so we can have a climbing thing. Do I just press jump? Is it? Yeah, cool. Oh, Can we get out the window? I'm hoping we were supposed to do that. Yep, looks like we were. Good. Oh, we're back here. Cool. If you remember in that opening bit, those doors with the weird statues opened because of the sword. Which we don't have. So we need to find another way to open it, I'm guessing. Anyway, yeah, I love this game. Might start to look at the minute because I'm just getting back used to it, but I do remember enjoying this game, and I was really looking forward to their next game, Team Ico's next game, which was going to be, I think it was called The Last Guardian, is that what it was going to be called? There was even like a demo film they showed at one point. It had this like giant like half dog, half bird creature that was like your companion. And like a lot of the games seemed to be based around using him to get past obstacles, which of course would be the case, but jump's really weird. But yeah, that was a few years ago now, I swear, and now we haven't heard anything since. So not sure whether it's because they were waiting for the PS4 to come out. But either way, seriously, it's been, well, I'm not sure when Shadow Plus came out now. It must have been a while ago because it was PS2. Even if it was late PS2. But still. Come on, guys. So, there's now a girl in the cage. Now, I may be wrong in this, but I'm pretty sure that the language they're speaking is not real. It's a made-up language. If I'm wrong, I'm sorry if I offended anyone with that. But I like the fact that, same with Shadow of the Colossus, that it's always subtitles because... to me, it adds to it. I always assume that it is a made-up language, especially Shadow of the Colossus. And, so, you know, I like the otherworldliness, is that the right word? Is that the right term? It's added to it by not having having English in it. So we've lowered the cage. Can I jump? Oh, this might be stupid, but I'm going to go for it. Oh, he survived. And go for that! I usually thought I just plummeted into his death then. Is there a quick way to jump down? No? Okay. One thing I didn't realise and just noticed is that there's no tutorial, was there? There was no, like, press this to do this, then this to do this. Which I do like in games. I like there to be a sort of... a learning curve for you rather than the actual story / player's growth, I suppose. Okay. See, this part I should remember, that's what... It seems like I know what I'm doing. It's because this bit I've probably played more than anything else, being the beginning of the game. Okay, so I've got to press a button to climb down the ladder. You just walk towards it and he starts climbing. Cool. I like that. Simple. Okay, so we can give a shout. Am I gonna... need to... Oh. Mate! Okay, so you can't jump onto the ladder, unfortunately. That's a shame. I would have liked to be able to do that. Is this gonna... Yeah, see, I thought so. Right, okay. I think I remember correctly that her name's Yorda, I think. I think it's the case. Because there is some debate that these two in this game are the two in Shadow Colossus. Okay, so she's speaking a language that even we don't understand. Love this game. Oh. So I forgot that. Kids with horns are sacrificed. And here's our enemies. Okay. I've got my whacking stick. And now, this is pretty much the game, okay? So, these shadow things will constantly try to take this girl. And we have to beat them with sticks to get them to stay away. Right, now, this next thing might seem strange and might seem like it would be annoying, but to be honest, I love it and I think it adds to it. Yorda doesn't move. I can talk to her to make her move, but then she'll stop again. The other thing I can do, I believe it's L1. Right, R1. Okay, R1 that shouts to her. Also, when I'm near her, I can hold her hand. And when I'm holding her hand, I can drag her! Oh, and she has the same power as the sword, which allows her to open doors. But, yeah, so escort quests in games usually are hated. And this game is like a whole game escort quest. So, and Yorda is quite defenseless, and like we actually have to help her climb things as well. Like I said, it might seem to would be annoying, but it does add to the story, and it adds to the whole mechanics of protecting this girl who has some sort of special power that she needs us, much as we need her, but you know, we do different things. And I love the animations of when you're walking while holding her hand, because she stumbles a little bit. That sounds horrible, but I mean, it seems natural, it's not just like they're walking, and for a game, I'll show you, I mean, oh, there's a trophy, like, watch, look, see, I just love how fluid the animation looks, especially for something like that. And this is the save point. You sit on the sofa, and, oh my god, look at this screen, this takes me back. Pardon me. Phlegmy. Anyway. To make sure everything's still recording. Don't you dare freeze here. Cool. I might attempt to do a 100% trophy playthrough of this game, because but I think it's one of the trophies is actually to complete the game in like, I think, I don't know, 2 hours? Something like that. It's really short time either way. I don't know if I'll even be able to do that. I mean, I'm going to have to be a lot more familiar with the game. But speedrun's always something I wish I could do, so maybe this would be the game I choose to do it with. Run! Okay. I had a feeling I could pick those up for some reason. Oh, crap. Get over here. You wanna... Oh, the little ones. Sorry. Yeah, the different types of shadow creature. They all look fairly similar. But there's these little ones you see scuttling. There's the human-sized ones, and there's flying ones, which do the most to annoy. Generally, because they can just pick her up and carry her to a portal. That's what I call these things. I really have no idea what I'm doing with that. I'm guessing I need to... Okay. Oh, I see. Come over here, Yoda. Oh, she's stuck. Oh. Cheers for that, Yoda. Maybe like an idiot. Get on these. This should... I'm guessing should do the trick. What are those boxes for, though? I don't know. Just gonna do a trip? No. Did she go down there again? Did she give me clues? Is that the point? Or is she just trying to be annoying? Oh! That. Is she trying to be annoying? No, she was literally telling me what I had to do. Once again, though, I like that. There was no need to word it, but she was just her looking at something. Should have been a hint, big enough hint to tell me that look at what she's looking at, but I was being stupid, so there we go. I'm pretty sure you do go through some places more than once, so maybe that other way, that door was a puzzle for later, or maybe that was another way we could have gone, and there's a secret, and instead, we didn't. We missed it. Maybe. Is that where we were before? Kind of been. Him. Oh shit. Okay. Right. Reminds me of like a Zelda. Oh, she shouts too. That's cute. Turn around. Other way. What is this? Oh, if I hold R1, it actually shows me where she is as well. I'm guessing I need to do something here. Oh, it's a lever. I couldn't really see what it was. Okay, so that's opened that door. So she's now gonna... Knew it! This becomes a rinse and repeat sort of process, to be honest. I don't think you do any heavier... Oh god, there's another one. But even if she gets to the portal, you can actually drag her out. Also, they will only take her to their own portal. So, if another one grabs her while you're attempting to drag her out, they will take her to the other side of the room. And the thing I remember learning was never, ever, run off to fight them. Stand by her and let them come to you. I don't think you can do any other hits with this. But you can do a jump hit. which I'm guessing would do more damage. I'm not sure. There's a safe point. Might as well use it while we can. Can I sit the other side of the sofa? No. Okay, maybe I'll have to sit the left side. I'm not sure why that bothered me. I just wanted to see if you could. Saving. Yes. Cool, so safe was only slow the first time. Good. Good to know. I'm going to play a load of this in one go. Because I'm not sure how long the game is. I'm guessing if there's a trophy for playing it in like a couple of hours, it can't be that long a game. But I don't really remember. I remember first time I played it took me a while, but then again, like, the puzzles later on, I did sometimes just confuse the hell out of me. I'm not the brightest when it comes to certain types of puzzle. I mean, I can do the game Catherine fairly well. That's a sliding block puzzle. I know it's pretty different. Can she climb the thing? Is she going to be able to? No. Okay, she can't climb the rope. Jane. What? I missed something again? There's a door out there for me to go, but will she be alright in here? That's my only problem. See, look, I'm worrying about her safety. That proves how this game affects people. How am I supposed to get her up there, though? Oh no, can I, no. Is there a place where it's lower? No. Hang on, this might work, I never know. Turn around. There's some sort of delay with the... Oh, maybe this does work. Okay, so she can jump further than I thought. Cool. I'm not sure if before there was actually loading screens every time you walked to a different area, like on the PS2 version, and they just made it smoother, like it's now on PS3, but yeah, that's my thought on that subject. Get a look at that view. I'm pretty sure we have to use that later, in some way. Looks like a physics puzzle. I love my physics puzzles. I don't really love them. They're alright. Okay, here we go again. It's gonna be the flying ones now. I hope not. Oh, and it is. Do land as well. Oh, that's a big one. Oh, nice save. I mean, okay, what I really wanted to say then was fuck, but you know, come on you, if I lose, or, is there a run, and I can't remember, is there a run button, oh, she's going to that one, cool, gives me more time. You haven't got to literally drag her out, it seems. You can just, you can, like... Okay, so no. Taking longer than it should. Yeah, if the blue light on their heads goes out, it means they're dead, I think. And then that happens. Oh, God, another one? There are places in this game where the enemies don't stop respawning, and you have to sort of do what needs to be done at the same time as fending them off constantly, which is where the game gets truly annoying. But like I said, I say annoying, but the game makes up for it in so many other ways. I mean, just look at that. Granted, today probably it's not as great a thing, like that scenery there, but though we have games like Skyrim, we have like fast landscapes all the time. But back then on the PS2, this was a huge thing for me, especially. The fact that there was just like this vast scenery to see. There's another reason about when we get around to Shadow Colossus, if you haven't seen Shadow Colossus and you're wondering why scenery is so important to me, you'll see when it comes to that game, that's a huge part of the game. Did she come down? Yeah, she can. Cool. Like I said, I don't think she... pretty sure she can climb down ladders. Where does this go? Right, this is definitely going to be something to do with a puzzle, if we tell. Okay, so unfortunately, if I hold the button and want to see where she is, he will constantly just shout. Look, I'm not even holding on to anything. She's badass. Okie dokie. Bonsoir? Sounds French. What's that? Sofa. No, it has to be left side. Save, yeah. Okay, and I think we've been playing for roughly half an hour, I think. Maybe, possibly. So we'll leave it there for today. I hope you've enjoyed this like little taster so far, because there's been this much more story-wise and gameplay mechanics to get into, I think, maybe. Possibly. Actually, no, gameplay mechanics probably what you've seen is probably all there is, actually. I could be wrong, who knows? But yeah, story wise there's much more to go into. Telling a story about telling a story, that's pretty much what this game's about. I love it. Hope you've enjoyed. Let me know in the comments below if you think I'm missing things or if there's stuff you want me to look out for. But until next time, guys, bye.